My name is Pernille, and I'm head of department of our sustainability team in Ramboll, Denmark. We're a big architectural and building consultancy firm with a lot of different expertise. Almost 17,000 people all around the world working with many different industries. We like to think of ourselves as sustainable society consultants. It's a part of everything we do.
I'm an architectural and construction manager working here in Ramboll. And a lot of the projects that we are delivering on are actually using GIS as the backbone. And a great case for doing so was the Danish Technical University.
My name is Julie Frankel, and I'm a project manager and an architect at the DTU Campus Service. DTU is the biggest technical university in Denmark. We have a big campus. It's 111 hectares. We have lots of students, and we have even more students coming in the future.
DTU came to us because they are building many square meters every year, and they had quite big expansion plans for the entire campus. And they wanted to make sure that it's developed sustainably.
I especially work on the 3D part of the platform, so my favorite tool is CityEngine. We are able to do almost anything, especially in the 3D world. And I've always had the idea that you could use CityEngine for sustainability modeling to really understand the world in the third dimension.
CityEngine and GIS are really perfect because they visualize what different changes in a project would look like in reality. Would there be more trees? How would that look? What about the volumes of the buildings? What would that actually affect on the architectural spaces on the campus? How would it feel for people to walk around in those spaces?
You could really quickly see what it meant, how the campus looks at the moment and how we wanted it to be fully built in the future, maybe in 40 or 50 years.
I think everybody wins with this visualization. The decision makers can see how their money are spent, and the municipalities can see how their environment is developed. GIS was a good match for this project because we work with the complexity of a certification system called DGNB. That's the one we primarily use in Denmark. It has a lot of criteria and a lot of data sets that we need to handle simultaneously.
As a technical university, we are very fond of technical solutions, but with the certification, we also have to be aware of social, economic, and other subjects. It's been the main method of us getting through this certification. It's a complicated process that used to be on paper with a pen and pencil. And if I have to go back to the spreadsheet, I'll probably quit my job.
In Ramboll, we have one goal, and that is sustainability. And GIS can certainly help us reach that goal.
This kind of technology is really crucial. I think the possibilities with these new technologies are endless.